Well, hey everybody. Today on the workbench, we have a high voltage mechanical flasher. Now, I've seen a couple videos of these online, but they were short, low quality videos and didn't really show anything that I wanted to see detail-wise of kind of the inner workings of how these operate. But I was able to get my hands on one of these, and I thought I would dig into it and bring it along with me so we could take a look. Now, this is a Signatrol Model 50, and Signatrol is no longer... Well, it was bought out or absorbed by FMS Corporation. They kind of consolidated their product lines. So this is a Model 50, was renamed a Model 55, and it is still being manufactured by FMS. But this particular model, if you can see, you can see a reflection of yourself there. There we go, December 2002, manufacture date on this guy. It is new old stock, and the way I know is when we look inside, still have the original documentation stuffed in here. So unused, brand new. I thought we'd put this to the test, see if we could get it working, see what happens. Now you may notice initial construction. It is made out of stainless steel. This is a pretty hefty, pretty thick gauge stainless steel. This, I'd say probably a millimeter and a half there, maybe 16th inch. And it is stainless because a high voltage flasher distributes the high voltage current, and that creates electrical arcing, which generates ozone. Ozone is highly corrosive, and you want stainless steel for something like this. So that is a one drawback of a high voltage flasher. Now, high voltage flashers are a little uncommon. More commonly used are the primary mechanical flashers that regulate the low voltage. They distribute the low voltage. So, for example, this is a 4-point primary mechanical flasher, and you'd hook up a transformer to each one of these, and each transformer would power its own circuit. But for some applications, that is not practical. For example, you wouldn't want to stuff four transformers into a smaller sign that has just, say, like four small aero tubes or something like that. And something like a high voltage mechanical flasher would be advantageous because you'd only need one transformer. And the way these work is has this ceramic distributor, if you will. It's kind of like a car distributor. You hook up the output, the secondary output of the transformer into the center, and these rotating points, contacts here, distribute the voltage to the outer contact points. Now, this is super simple, as you can probably tell. It just has this little coil in here that generates a magnetic field and spins this disc. And the disc rotates the spark gap distributor there. And you can, I believe this magnet here controls the speed at which this disc spins. This documentation here is pretty cool. Model 50, old Signatrol information. Shows a little details here on how to flash particular patterns of neon tubes using various flashers here. They came in 4, 6, and 8-point flasher on these high voltage flashers. And then it also comes with a part list as well. But what I wanted to do is hook this guy up. I want to test it to see if it actually works. I believe it will, since it is new old stock, and I have no reason to believe it will not. So if we hook this up to, this is the motor is 110 volt input, the motor that drives the disc inside. Well, the motor that creates the magnetic current that spins the disc, shall we say. So all I'm going to do is hook this up, and I believe this should just start spinning for us. Ready? 3, 2, 1. And there it goes. That's pretty cool. Very simple design, so not a whole lot to break down in here. Let's see if this magnet actually adjusts the speed here. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, I don't know if you can hear it. It's you can probably see it's spinning a lot slower. It sounds slower as well. Move this out of the way. It should speed it up. Hey, there it goes. That's pretty fast for a fast flashing arrow. Cool. So this does work. I was expecting it to, so that's good. What I want to do now is I want to hook up a transformer. We'll hook up the high voltage, the secondary circuits here, and get four tubes and see what we can do. Get this thing flashing. All right, so we moved to the bending table because there's more room over here. And I have four tubes of various colors hooked up to the distributor cap. Automotive term, yeah, there you go. And that's connected, of course, to the secondary lead on the transformer. This is a 7500 volt, 30 milliamp transformer. And then the secondary lead of that is connected in series to the ends of each of the tubes. So the current goes through in there, gets distributed each one, boom, 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 and then it'll come back to the other secondary post there. So we got the primary wiring all hooked up, and all that we gotta do is flip that switch on the wall. So let's see what this looks like in action. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Wow! That is a lot of arcing. That's fun though. Ooh, psychedelic. Epilepsy warning there, yeah. Look at that, look at the arcing in there. I'm sure the manufacturer does not recommend running this without the cover on there. Wow. I am not gonna mess with that little magnet to adjust the speed while this is on. I'll turn it off and then we'll try at a slower speed. All right, I got that magnet shoved in there and we'll turn this back on. Ready, 3, 2, 1. So yeah, a lot of arcing there. Definitely. I'm not surprised that this generates a lot of ozone. Hey there. So yeah, secondary or high voltage mechanical flasher, useful for flashing multiple tubes with one transformer. Very nice. I like seeing the inside of it in action. Hope you guys liked it. Hit subscribe for more neon related videos and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.